Dr. Freda Heiweru-Lemera, the presidential advisor in charge of general duties, emphasizes that the high malaria prevalence rates in Uganda, which need concerted efforts to curb, the government through the Malaria Consortium Program and Control has distributed many long-lasting treated insecticide mosquito nets to help in combating malaria prevalence in Uganda. But in areas like Kagadi, more awareness is needed for people to embrace preventive measures. According to the World Health Organization, Uganda has one of the world's highest malaria incidence rates of 478 cases per 1,000 population per year. It is also a leading cause of sickness and death in Uganda and is responsible for up to 40% of all outpatient visits, 25% of hospital admissions, and 14% of all hospital deaths.
If you fall sick, you should take malaria. As a family, certainly we will conserve hygiene, I mean, public service precautions. Like, one, you have to close the windows early enough.
Kagadi District recently received 306,960 insecticide-treated mosquito nets to be distributed over 30 sub-counties of Kagadi District, but some leaders indulged in selling the mosquito nets for other domestic purposes, while some were arrested for misusing the donated nets. Agbas Nwamaya says that many children in school have been facing a challenge of malaria in the boarding section, disrupting smooth learning progress, asking residents to ensure that they encourage their children to sleep under treated mosquito nets during holidays. Nurses and some Kagadi residents say that lack of education and ignorance causing misuse and laxity is an obstacle to malaria prevention in the district, hence the need for more sensitization. You should use improvised dustbins to dispose off wastes and ensure you sleep under treated insecticide mosquito nets as a measure to curb malaria prevalence in our district. You should ensure children during holiday are engaged in safety measures against problems. Recent reports show a staggering malaria positivity rate in Kagadi, which stands at 61%. It means that out of 100 patients who test, 61 turn out positive, with most affected being children below 12 years. Story compiled by Andrew Musingzi for the news.